Hey everyone, today I'm going to attempt the impossible. I'm going to try to win in standard without playing black cards. Okay, maybe not impossible since people have literally been doing it. I'm actually going to be shamelessly stealing deck lists from Crokeys, from Hogpog, from Brecaroni, I believe. Crokey has been crushing with this blue white list on the ladder. I think he was 21-3. I actually played this deck a few matches as well. I won 4 out of 4, 5 out of 5. Was blue white control-ish mid-range hybrid tap out deck, but blue white nonetheless. And yeah, I've had very little success in standard. It was really anything. I've usually won more than I've lost with most of the decks I've tried, but nothing convincing. And that was kind of the first deck where I was just winning just winning in general, winning streak. So we'll see if I can keep going. So yeah, just playing kind of cheap counterspell, make this appear pretty versatile. And then you have just annoying creatures up the curve. Obviously, Wandering Emperor. AO is kind of an all-star right now in standard. It has Vigilance, so it dodges the minus of Wandering Emperor. It's also pretty annoying against the black removal because none of it really exiles. I guess there's Soul Transfer, but that card's not played in too many copies usually. So that guard's good. You have access to Farewell, even though I've been boarding out the card a decent bit. And Teferi's been surprisingly good, just decent value engine, and survives Farewell, survives Meat Hook Massacre, just pretty solid in general. The plus kind of comes up when you untap a Bang Buster, for example. So yeah, card's been solid. You're still, you know, struggling if they curve into multiple Invoke Despair. That's been my biggest issue in this format, was a lot of the decks I've built, and yeah, just Invoke Despair being pretty hard to beat in general. But yeah, solid mana base, solid curve. I wasn't super sold on Adeline when I saw the list, but it's been good for me. Denik is decent against your reanimator stuff. It has lifelink, provides a little value in the late game with Disturb. And Spirit Companion has just been kind of the glue, you know, just decent with Wedding Announcement, decent to like protect your Planeswalkers. It's also an enchantment, I guess, you can sack to Invoke Despair if you need to and save your Wedding Announcement potentially. Sideboard's been okay as well. Nothing too crazy. Haven't really been sideboarding too heavily. But yeah, that's the first deck I'm going to try. I'll also be trying a band deck that Hawkpog used to top four standard Magic Online Challenge, and Brecaroni also top four the same challenge with a Gruul list, aggressive deck. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, I'm trying to get to Mythic, ideally top 250 Mythic before the end of the month, which gives you an invite to the Arena Qualifier, the monthly Arena Qualifier that can qualify you to Arena Championship. So that would save me having to try and grind planes and stuff. There's a whole system to qualify. It's kind of tough. There's only 32 players who qualify per like season, which is about 3 or 4 months for each Arena Championship. Pretty exclusive tournaments, but I guess if you make it, you're guaranteed a pretty decent payday and just prestigious tournament, I guess, pretty exclusive. So I've been trying to qualify. I haven't had any chance to. It was the first one. I had 1 day 2 in one of the qualifiers, but it was enough. 6 lands. I had the value lands, but 6 lands still too many. And then just when in doubt, bottom the expensive card, especially when you have already another copy. So yeah, I've definitely been struggling on the ladder. Ooh, I'm playing ugly basics. It's definitely not cruising this season. I could maybe try and play other formats like Explorer or Historic. I quite like the Esper. Not super common. Esper is usually just Rafine, just kind of what I'm playing, like good cards up the curve, probably Rafine, Wandering Emperor, etc. It's Kaido, Shizuki, sure. Kaido being pretty good for them right now. Give them a ton of value. played a pretty sweet deck with Tezzeret, actually. It was four color Grease Fang, had four mana Tezzeret, and the combination of Tezzeret and Bangbuster was super, super good. So I wonder if this deck couldn't use like one or two Tezzerets, just another card advantage engine that can take over the game. All right, this thing is not protected anymore. Cannot crew Reckoner. I don't want to use my land, I want to play it. Yeah, I guess I just... Do I want to force a trade here? I get to draw a card if you attack with two creatures next turn. I think I'm okay trading, even though my token's potentially going to be bigger because I have double wedding announcements.
I was hoping you wouldn't notice me.
But yeah, tried that deck. It looked kind of promising, but I played a bit more and the wheels kind of fell off. Maybe it was all tuning. It was Esper splashing Fable for, or splashing red for Fable of the Mirror Breaker. It had the four mana vehicle that shoots things when it's summoned into play. It's like four mana when it enters a battlefield, you deal 2x damage to a creature or planeswalker, where x is the number of vehicles you control, so at least 2 damage for itself. And if you have a bang buster out already, it's 4 damage. That card was kind of solid. Jeez. Wow. All right. Can't really attack. I mean, did they just not use... Oh, yeah. Attack the last turn. They plused it to draw a card. And I think I'm just going to slam AO, but... AO, let's see. I've been chatting away. Bangbuster attacking. They can just block with a token and free 2. Yeah, I guess there's just not much to it, right? Just AO, say go, get a lot of tokens, and hope to just swarm them. That's double wedding announcement. For those of you wondering, it's nothing bad. I just gave my blood earlier. So proudly showing off the bandage. I actually started doing it just recently. I don't know why I've never done it before. Waited till I was 37 years old to start giving my blood. Kind of a shame, or... You know, maybe not a shame, but I don't know why I waited so long. Just never really thought of it. And super easy to wear, like where I live in Paris. No excuse.
There's no secret I can't uncover.
Yeah, they put you that huge bandage and stuff. All right, my turn. Bonesoe's ready. So my Bangbuster is a 5/5. I'm gonna lose a token if I attack with everyone. Should I just start by drawing a card maybe? I'm taking a lot of damage on the way back to 6, 8, 11, 15. Potentially 4 more if they have an underdog. I'm gonna just draw a card. Should maybe just wait a turn, honestly. Just draw a card. Just attack with AO. All right, I could slam Teferi into a counter. I don't love it.
Time to go.
But I'm not too sure what I should be worried about. Farewell's not the end of the world. don't know. I guess I should just play Trinket Cove and say go. Keep Counterspell mana up. Double Ultimate Guard logo, jeez. I'm messing around. Except for my sponsor's logo and I have Ultimate Guard. Because that's the scene I use when I stream too. Alright, no Wandering Emperor still. Just not using their mana at all. You usually want to get rid of the Planeswalker, especially when it's something that's drawing cards and stuff. It's pretty rare to have a Planeswalker that's not going to give them some kind of value. Okay. I mean, I guess just attack with everyone. Doesn't look like they have two profitable blocks. I mean, they can trade up a tiny bit, but I'm still pushing a lot of damage through. Like they're trading a 2-2 for a 3-3, but it's probably worth it. They have Hermit, so I don't think I want to play the Fairy. Probably just play maybe even basic planes, say go. I guess I could have drawn on my turn. I could have drawn an Adelaine, something along these lines. It's gonna kill a token, it's gonna give them something like... It's not gonna give them too much though. It's gonna kill a token. Which I'm gonna lose anyways if I casualty gained them two life. I think it's fine.
You started this fight, but I'm going to end it. I am almost sad to see you go.
AO just selling. I was talking about it during deck tech. That card's just been ridiculous.
Remember your training.
Kind of dodges everything. And by everything, I mean minus two of Wandering Emperor. Always gives you great value in this deck too. You're gonna get Wandering Emperor, Adelaine, or like double two drops sometimes. I'm gonna try to counter that. Probably not even that good for them if it resolves. Nah. And I guess it gains them the life and stuff. And this way I just kill them and they have nothing else, which they probably don't because they haven't been doing anything. Yeah, good enough. Good enough. Alright, blue or Esper. Destroy Evil could be okay, kills me, they might have Shield Dread, not the greatest though. Syncopate seems fine, all these cards seems okay, I guess Denik's not super great. And then Farewell, I've just been boarding out Farewell for the most part, especially if they have Hermit, maybe keep one in. And just maybe more counters. Peacekeeper could be okay too. Could be like one destroy build, one peacekeeper. Not too sure. Maybe I should sideboard a bit more. Yeah, awkward. Awkward, no untap plan for two. I'm not sure you need Tranquil Quiver as many. It's been kind of a pain. Yet it's a pain. It gains you life, but it's a pain. Funny. I need to keep keeping track, but I feel like the current play tap has hurt me a decent bit. Obviously, the mana is not perfect if you start cutting dual lands, though, so... I mean, yep, maybe cut one or two. I mean, this game feels kind of over. Maybe Peacekeeper can get me out of it. It's Peacekeeper naming Kaido, right? Activate the ability of Source with a chosen name, cost two more to activate. You know, I can slow them down a tiny bit. That's assuming they don't have anything good in hand. Interceptor, negate. Oh, jeez. Whew. I mean, maybe I should just name Interceptor? I guess so. I was going to name Thingy, but... Oh, look at that. Oh, choose a card name. So, oh, okay. Obscura Interceptor. Maybe I can pressure Kaido if they don't have a play here. Alright, one time. Hold. Ah, brutal. Well, I get to resolve one spell. Choose it wisely. Jeez. Negate thingy. Maybe just wedding announcement. It's kind of highest impact spell. Is it? Maybe it's not higher impact than Reckoner Bind Buster.
Thanks.
It's coming play tap line really kill me. I mean, I'm not even sure what I'm supposed to do at this point.
I'll find another way.
Might have something else to have another counter. Jeez. Just counter everything. Why not? I can just jam over and over again and not die and eventually resolve some spells.
Now this,
and they're drawing two cards a turn. This game is pretty much over. I'm not sure why I'm still playing. Even if I resolve a spell one day, they're just so far ahead. And an underdog now. Should I scoop? I'll be over soon enough.
Now,
What do we have here?
This man in counterspells. He's coming to play tap land and really hurt me. I'm not sure it would have made a difference if I'd been able to play a card on turn two, but really did not help. I mean, you gotta assume they have negate or something. And even if they... I'm just gonna assume they just don't have anything. Even though they gotta have negate for it if they're tapping out like that.
You almost stopped me that time.
Maybe I'll just play the AO actually. If they have negate or make this. Maybe they just have negate and not make disappear. Not have make disappear, yeah. Doing free to keep drawing. Underdog. I mean, they would have to tap out. Only have one card in hand. Maybe they'll be like, oh, they only have one card in hand. Let's go.
Now this is a juicy secret.
Doesn't look like they're gonna tap out, shockingly. Okay. Just have a blocker, why not? Well, looks like I'm taking a beat down. Not quite ready to give up though. You never know. You just never know. You kind of do know, but you know. All right. All the black cards prevail.
Thanks. I'll be taking that now.
Hope not. Whole point of this video is to showcase the non-black cards beating the black decks. All right. You got me. Okay, I'm gonna not have Farewell because it feels like too little too late to have a million counterspells. Some kind of my cheap cards, maybe Spell Pierce could be good. Not very good against Interceptor though. Hearst doesn't seem like the worst, but Hearst's been kind of underwhelming in my experience. Could trim AO, but I think it's... I want something to punish them if they do tap out. Maybe Destroy Evil is just not that good against them. Too narrow. Spell Pierce is in full stroke. I think I'm just going to stick with the main deck counter spells. Alright, my turn. Let's see if I can curve out. Not exactly current out, but good enough. Well, good enough to keep. Hopefully good enough to win. Come on, Spirited Companion. Nice. Counter would have been good too, just countering basically anything would have been nice. Which one should I play first? Oof. You'll love to see it. You absolutely love to see it. All right, I'm definitely playing Peacekeeper first to mess up their curve. So they have Winning Announcements, they have Rafine, they have Denig, they have two Rafines. I mean, it's got to be Rafine, right? Rafine actually blocks stuff. What's it called? Raffing Scheming Seer. Wow. I mean, to be fair, they didn't have a Make Disappear or anything, so seem reasonable for them to play what they played. Just add a lane first, I guess. That thing's kind of annoying. So is it stack? I think it probably stacks. Not sure why it wouldn't stack. Meat Hook Massacre. Can counter that. I think I kind of want to name Rafine again. This can attack. I'm gonna get another 1/1 attacking anyways. And this can attack as well, I think. My double block Peacekeeper. Then I kill Denik to take 5, 6, 7. I counter their next spell. I can let Rafine resolve. Or to kill that, clear Rafine. Maybe let Rafine resolve. I think this is good for me. I'm not keeping Peacekeeper right away, but maybe not. Feel like Meat Hook resolve. See, like Fancy Place Syndrome though. That card doesn't do much for them. Plus I lose a token, which is not like nothing.
It's like your defenses aren't even there.
Yeah, I guess Wedding Announcement is just single-handedly beating me this game. Damn. And now they start drawing two cards a turn. Can I get through this turn if I attack with everyone? Then it goes on a lifelink. Let's see. Then it goes on a Peacekeeper. Double block. I mean, I get wrecked. Wow. Just kind of lose. Just flood it out a bit. Can't really say the black cards got them. It's just like Wedding Announcement, I guess. Yeah, I should have countered Kaido. That was a mistake, big mistake. Somehow I didn't realize how and like how bad of a spot I was in. Jeez. Should I just play Wedding Announcement? I mean, do I really care if they meet Hook Massacre? Kind of want to counter Rafine, I guess. All right, well, we're both drawing two cards a turn, I guess. Yeah, I just completely punted. I would have been just fine this game if I'd countered Kaido. Wow.
Now this is a juicy secret.
Just, yeah. Can I keep up? Ah, I'm bummed. That was easy win. Easy win if I counter Kaido. Could maybe still win, but kind of seems unlikely. I can't uncover. Yeah. It's not gonna help matters. Oh my god. How do I punch through? Just a dragon. AO. How desperate am I? Yes, I'm not countering match anyways.
I won't explain what I'm about to do, but I'd rather show than tell.
What if I tap Denig? Do I actually have a decent attack?
And some think time only flows in one direction.
Might have a reasonable attack. No, there's no way. Probably just gonna meat hook massacre for one. Why wouldn't they? Yeah. I'm pissed. I'm really pissed. Just snuck up on me. The wedding announcement poem was like, wow, what just happened? My board's worthless. And they have Hauling Mine going.
Show you how it's done.
It's so soul tricky. No, there's nothing tricky about it, right? Just me took massacre for one. I'm gonna need a little help here. I'm gonna need them to maybe make a mistake or two.
I know something you don't
like
know.
Tap out for Rafine this turn. Yeah. This game, like, was still somewhat close. Imagine if I just countered that first Kaido. Would have been pretty easy, I think. My board did very well, obviously, because I was trying to just play the tempo game, and now, I mean... my own cards, but... Doesn't really do anything at this point. More cards, more wedding announcements. Is there still the dragon? The hope of the dragon. Still one card that could maybe save me, but even that's probably gonna be too little too late.
Thanks. I'll be taking that now.
All right, well. I feel like that's still like a decent showing for the deck. If it wasn't for like one really bad mistake.
But I'm taking the credit when we win. I'm tired of your secrets.
Kind of sucks just winning all the games earlier on stream and just no good here. Feels bad. I think I'm just going to scoop them up. This is painful. I don't know why I do it to myself.
There's no secret I can't.
You won't be outsmarting me.
Good news is, it could probably come counter it. Probably a turn too late. Maybe if that card had come like a turn earlier, that would have been good. Wasn't that far off. Maybe I should have like suicide attacks, a few cards to draw two of my wedding announcements. Maybe I could two counters on all my creatures? Doesn't even matter, right? Can probably just two-shot me, plus I have huge lifelinker. Two huge lifelinkers, I guess we'll see. Plus I have to deal with the planeswalkers first, probably. If I draw another AO, palm the team.
Oh, whoops, you caught me. It's gonna be fun watching you fail to stop us.
Off you go.
Probably just dead, right? We'll see. I'll live. If I can live, maybe I'm in business, because it's pretty all-in-ish attack by them. It's not even close to me living. I believe the answer is not close. Well, that's kind of unfortunate. Oh man, good games. Alright, let's do one more with this deck. Let's see if I can redeem myself. Anyway, while I try to redeem myself, I'd like to shout out the sponsor of the video. Channel Fireball, of course, but also Ultimate Guard. Ultimate Guard has amazing product, deck boxes, sleeves. I have all of the stuff behind me, some of the stuff on my desk. You've got your traditional kind of, you know, deck boxes for quote unquote normal Magic deck. You've got these ones. You've got the boulders, which is like renewable material, a bit more sturdy. I got some pretty modern deck that I built a while ago that I never played with. Looks like Oath of Druids. They have the sleeves, katana sleeves. They have bigger boxes for a cube. That's the Omnihive Xenoskin. It's 1,000 cards worth of box. It can fit a 1,000 card, I believe, maybe double sleeve cards, so maybe even more single sleeves. And yeah, they're great. They have a really cool website too, ultimateguard.com. You can find all their products. You can buy their stuff if you live in Europe. You can also check out their blog. And you can buy their stuff directly on the website if you live in Europe. And I think if you live in the US, you go through eBay, but you can still order Ultimate Guard product in the US. And yeah, there's a cool blog section where I write, Reed writes, LSV, Gabby, the whole team, the whole crew. So check it out. All right, Samao. Kind of mono free drops here. You do have a decent gear if you do have a lot of twos, but Lutrankin Cove, maybe a mirror match, maybe another Crokey's fan. I'm gonna play Adeline first because I have two and they might have made disappear. Nope. Alright, gonna play Ganjo. They could have their own. I will write them if they're relying on that Ganjo. That could be nasty. Yeah. Yikes. That's like nightmare scenario for them. Jeez. What a beating. Wandering Emperor. They're gonna get to eat another 1-1 no matter what. I think I'm gonna make a token free combat so that my alien just hits a tiny bit harder. Yeah.
Feel the energy of battle.
Or just get wedding announcement going. Draw a card, etc. Well, I guess they get to. Never mind, a Adeline to block. We're gonna say they get to pump and attack pressure Wandering Emperor. My plan is to play the standard showcase this weekend. I've actually not played standard on Magic Online in years, but the showcase to Saturday Standard and figured why not. So hopefully these few matches help me a bit pick a deck. I have recording this on Thursday, so I'm going to be playing a bit of Standard tomorrow. Then I have to pick something to play the showcase, but yeah, it's been kind of interesting trying to figure out what's good besides the black based decks. And it seems like some talented deck builder might have figured out a thing or two, so we'll see. All right, let's see. And attack was all. I think I'm okay ignoring. Am I? No, I'm gonna send Adeline at Teferi alone. And I'm gonna send the two tokens at the Wandering Emperor. I'm actually not gonna ignore the Planeswalkers. There's no rush. Just pick them apart. And here, probably just play Bangbuster.
I'm never done for good.
I think this bird's been pretty impressive. Really, really good. Really important. Lots of 4, 5, 6 mana spells you have to counter. Let's just syncopate here. 4 obvious reasons.
Nothing like a change of plans to keep things fresh.
All right, let's see. I guess I'll just max pressure and send everything at them, I guess. Is that lethal? 4, 8, 9, depth chump. Okay, so I'm gonna let them chomp Adeline and finish off Teferi.
It's only a matter of time.
Yeah, being on the play, having that Adeline Emperor play was just too much. Yeah, I've not liked relying on Farewell, especially because it doesn't sweep the Planeswalkers. Evil seems good in the mirror, kills Adeline, kills Wedding Announcement. Guess kills Aira, not that you really want to kill that card. Denik seems kind of medium. I mean, helps the board, but probably just do more counters. Really? Oh no. Webcam. It's because I'm like just chilling. So this deck I've played a bunch before this video. The other two I've just seen seen pictures of. I think I might have played against a red green deck on the ladder. Maybe even against a banned one once. So we'll see. We shall see what happens. All right, opponent. What you got for us? I went and checked out the Paris tournament, the big Paris tournament last weekend. Harry MTG was doing commentary, was actually staying with me. He stayed with me for a few days before, a few days after as well, because he got stuck in Paris. Just they booked his flight for the wrong date, and he tried and he kind of like got, so ended up hanging out a few extra days. It was fun, it was nice. But yeah, that was fun. I actually went to the site on Friday with him, kind of hung out, said hi. I had the wedding of one of my best friends, so I couldn't actually play the tournament. It was Modern. The main event was Modern. I'm not sure what I would have played, because there's nothing that really stands out to me in Modern right now. Probably just four colors or Modern or Murktide. So you could go counter into wedding, which would be kind of bad for me, but just going to lead with Companion, because I need to make my land drops. And obviously I don't have a counter, so keeping mana up doesn't make too much sense unless you have, you know, pretty strong raids. I would have gotten God, actually, because it does kill most of the free drops. Kim's Wedding Announcement and Adeline, but yeah, that would have been awkward. But yeah, I went and I finally started giving away some of the Ultimate Guard stuff that they send me. They send me like deck boxes and sleeves every once in a while, and I've not been using them. So it was cool to just meet people, and basically anyone who came and said hi, I had, you know, either a deck box or some sleeves for them. So that was kind of cool. All right, the Wandering Emperor, and I just drew a second one. Beautiful. So what does that leave me was just Bangbuster, I guess. Jig is up, no counters. That seemed pretty decent to me. Lands are nice. I probably have Wandering Emperor. Can I do something about it? Not really. Just played Denix, they go. Damn, they know my entire hand. No, minus one card. Ooh, caught a break. No Wandering Emperor. That's huge. Because this is only for opponents. It's not too bad for now. It's actually good for me. They should have maybe played it post-combat. I guess they're just not attacking. Just gonna start drawing cards. Maybe that's bad. Maybe I'm supposed to go like evil into AO. Just make them have it. I think I can just say go here. Just kind of maybe even bait them into attacking, get the free life link, kill the Adeline, have negate back up. Did kill Adeline. It was an attack on the stack, though. This way, okay, nothing. All right, sure. I'll try and get rid of it. Why not? Oh, Alright, this is going good for us. Thought I was going to get out tempoed, but they just don't appear to have much. Interesting. Is it? No, probably not, just wedding. Could try and force things. Oh. Okay. Alright, do I want to attack here? Probably. Damn, they're down to no cards. Jinxed it. All the cards now. Jesse's two make disappear, so damn, I'm probably just gonna play dragon. It is tempting to go like gangbuster or draw a million cards. Get the crew token to start beating them down. That might actually be better use of my mana. Just thinking, not so great so far. I'm 0-1 against the black decks and I guess probably about to be 1-0 in the mirror. Not the most convincing, but I swear I was beating a bunch of black decks earlier. If you like blue-white, if you're pit up of the black decks, I think you should give this deck a try. It's been pretty solid. It's been playing out nicely. I don't know. The deck's been pretty coherent and stuff. Especially, I've been impressed by Make Disappear. I think is maybe the standard card for me in this deck. Not that it's. I mean, it's been that card's been fine for a while now, but you know. Do have negate for Wandering Emperor. Could attack with more. Lazy, I guess. Just not really thinking things through. So I need to worry a tiny bit about Farewell, which means I could just get the fairy going. I guess I'll play AO this turn. I should have just played the fairy pre-combat and tabbed the Peacekeeper. I kind of forget it has that ability too. And here this is playing AO was, I guess it's okay because I have negate. I could have also just said go. Oh, never mind. Wandering Emperor is still 6 mana. Oh, yikes. Okay. Not exactly getting them ahead. Let me know, by the way, I was wondering when I started making this video, do you like these videos where I showcase a bunch of different decks? Or would you rather just me pick one deck when I make these arena videos and just stick with it? Let me know in the comments, if you like this format, or if, you know, you're happy to see maybe like 2 or 3 different deck lists, or if you'd rather have, you know, me maybe pick the one I think is the best, or that people will like the most, and just stick with this one. All right. Untap an artifact, whatever. Tap that creature. Untap a land. 6 mana. Through. True. I think I'm just going to play double 1/1. Roof, roof. So cute. She formed a friendship with several playful spirits, and soon the pack was known as a source of much mischief in Agarantia. Okay. Is that enough, though? Probably not. I'm not even gonna block. You won't know when. Payback's coming. Oh. All right. That went better. All right, let's maybe do the red green one first. Actually, not exactly what's in the red green list. I loaded it up just before the video. Let's see. Let's do quick deck tech. Boom, boom. Four Kumano faces Kakazan. That card's just an all-star. If you can cast it. I mean, it's obviously a little less reliable than if you're playing mono red, but we've got 13 on taps versus a red on, oops, on turn one. That was almost bad. Almost like slammed the cable with my foot. The Phoenix Chick, I'm still not sure I see it, but it is kind of good with Kumano, and that card's been seen playing Pioneer, so why not? Your other good one drop, Path Leader. That card kind of hits hard, kind of annoying, kind of a must kill. That card kind of have to get rid of it fast. That card, 3-2 trample for 2 kicker. +1/+1 haste until turn. Why not? Squee, I've been impressed by that card. That card's actually been a beating to Thundering Raiju. I've lost that card a bunch recently out of a bunch of different decks. Then Halana's super solid. 17, 9, 16, 20, 24 lands. You kind of have to. You have Loamseeker as kind of a menacing too. No Fable. No Fable is kind of making a statement, you know. I'm all in. No Fable of the Mirror Barrier. Okay. Too slow. Don't really need decks for mana. Let's see it. It does seem like the kind of deck that would be pretty draw dependent. They're also not playing the werewolf. That werewolf is still illegal. The 2/3/4 red and 2 that pumps creature, gives them haste. It does like shut down. It's not great. No man lands also really hurts a deck like that. That one's kind of rough. No one drop, right? They won't play that first. Ooh, okay. Fading Hope. Maybe a Leer deck? As for Leer? Let's just play two spells in case they have a spot removal or a counter spell. Make their life a little bit tougher.
I bring my own army.
Okay. Whenever it But then could counter on that, have a 5/5. Could have a free squee. I get an extra 1/1, but it just crashes into that. It's probably just that, right? I wish I could have used all my mana, but I'll have to do.
Darkness, I return.
Swore it's just bigger than the elf. All right. No vigilance, right, to get around. Oh, they don't have double whites. Okay. I don't want to play Helana into counter. What do you have? You attacked? What was your lifelink token? Instead of keeping a blocker for my 2/2. I'll say not sure what to have. I guess I'll just say Helana and Elena. They might have some flash monster? Oh, I guess not. Farewell, maybe? Meatoke Massacre. Okay. I could just kill them, probably not, but let's see. Play a land because I've made disappear. Attack was all. Put a counter on, I don't know, the trample creature. Alright, I like my chances. Hard to say, they could have shield draft out of sideboards. 5 damage, target creature or planeswalker. Feel like they should have shield draft at least in their sideboard. One green, deal X. It's not clear it kills a shield red though. Arlan's usually pretty good against control decks. Let's see. Let's see. Yes, planeswalkers are really bad against Invoke Despair. But the miners get two wolves, it's kind of nice. I'll do one rending flame. Yeah, I'll just do rending, two rending flames. Shield Red just stops me in my tracks. Alright, I'm gonna keep it simple, I guess. Lots of cards I could bring in. Could bring in Safekeeping. It's Safekeeping doesn't somehow counter Invoke Despair, right? Doesn't just protect here, right? Yeah, target prone you control. A good one to lead with, I guess. Good fodder, removal fodder. Yeah. More good fodder. Whew. Oops, top right. Here I am. All right, so let's hope they don't have another meat hook. Ooh, Halana and Beast Caller. Ooh, Beast Caller and Haste, even better? Not sure. Not sure which one was better, but this is cooler. Double Beast Caller, let's go. The Beast Caller, when it dies, you just get to put the counters wherever you want. And like Arcbound Ravager. Okay. Okay. Does this still have trample? I should have so. All right. Not bad. Not bad at all. Ooh, rank up. Let's go. Diamond tier 2. My rank's gonna be solo if and when and if I make it to Mythic. I'm gonna be like in the low 90% probably. Struggle has been real this season. I wasn't good in limited at first. Kind of cruising in limited. Ball. Ball out of control. Ooh, wow. Fabled one drop, very nice. Okay. All right, I guess I'll do that then. I was gonna just play Loam Speaker, maybe I still should have, but getting the counter on Loam Speaker is a bit underwhelming. This is gonna be kind of nice. Let's see if I can power through wedding announcements. Looking okay so far. Oh wow. Got Jadar, cool. Can I punch through? If Helana lives, Helana lives, I might be able to. And what else am I gonna do? It's gonna be bad if they have the Wandering Emperor, but I think I should still attack. Don't look like the block of someone who is a Wandering Emperor, but maybe. Gets exile too, which is nice. Alright, I want to play around Farewell. I guess not. X, 5-3. Five free lifelink, eh? It's a cool looking goblin. I don't get it though. Why is the goblin so big? Looks like huge. Oof, meat hook. It's got a meat hook. Okay. Oh, I have enough. All right, hold. Wow, figured I'd at least one more turn. All right, farewell, removal, massacre, wedding announcement, lifelink stuff. I mean, I feel like any of these cards could be okay in small numbers. Just board out Pack Leader, but it's always the same thing. You board out the one drops because they have one toughness, and you're like, oh, to just get blocked so easily, but. It's also about tempo. You're like forcing them to trade maybe something that costs a bit more or put multiple tokens in the way and it just didn't cost you much because it was your one drop and you would have not had another one drop anyway. So it's kind of free in some ways. Any spirits? Here's a spirit, right? No, spirit on the other side. Part of me does not really want to sideboard at all. You know what? Let's do that. No changes. Main deck's just perfect. opponent.
Anything I try to stand up and listen to it here and there.
Got a mulligan. If that was Carplucent Forest, maybe. I mean, it's not much better, but. Yikes. All right, good thing there's a third game. Yikes. Thanks. I'll be taking that now. Mine's a pretty cool looking kind of spooky. Wow.
A juicy secret.
All right, so we'll get rid of Kaido and I'll just have to raise these two. Mission impossible. Let me know in the comment if I should scoop some of these games sooner. Oh, they're not putting the counters on Rafine? What? It's so weird. Meat hook, Rafine. Do the planeswalker. I think I'm gonna stick to no changes. Definitely don't want to keep the one cut the one drops on the play. Sure. Where's my one drop? Bad face. Too bad that doesn't untap. That'd be kind of sick. Pretty nasty tempo swing. Want some catch up? I thought I was off to a good start. That just feels eh. And I can get this card going, or I could just deal a bunch of more damage. Hmm. We also just play a second Loam Speaker. Not good. Well, yeah, it might be better for me than if it was Wandering Emperor. Can I just not block though? Is that the third Esper deck I play against today? How miserable attack. Oh, I'm gonna need something really good. I'm gonna need one of my four drops. Okay, it could be worse.
I could sneak right by, but our eyes are everywhere.
This attack was everyone. Oh my god. Well. What a misclick. What a freaking misclick. That sucks. Wow. I'm so pissed. God, I barely got any damage through. I drew up a squeeze. I mean, I was impressed with squeeze. I was actually thinking about that, like, looking at the deck list and playing these few games. I'm not sure about multiple squeeze, especially when you have stable, you have like some decent free drops, if you want more free drops. Seems all sketch. And this game's just over.
Run away. You
can see. Most likely.
This is what you get for hurting my people.
Too bad it's not Planeswalker. I think I should have attacked everything at Kaido here just to not let them snowball. Wasn't gonna cost me too much. I'm so dead.
Now this is a juicy secret.
Alright, looks like another 1-1 for the non-black decks. Not the most convincing I'm trying over here. Check. I mean, didn't have a 2/5 Rafine, it would be good. 2/5 Make the land, attack with everyone, they go block, block. Yeah, I mean, maybe if I'd made the land last turn, it would have been a little closer. A little scarier for them. Have something. They are pretty low, but I'm not sure how I deal the last 2 points of damage. Man, Kaido's been good for my opponents. What a meat hook. Thanks. I guess I should just jump. I mean, they gotta have meat hook right to make that attack. Or worse. It was calculated, but they put them down to 1. 1 is not 0, though. Alright. Good games. Defeat. Alright. Doesn't seem like these aggro decks should really work on paper, but I've played against them and played against some white red too. They're pretty resilient. Is Showdown still standard legal? Is it not? No more Saga. Showdown. Guess not. Yeah, I don't know. On the paper, seems like you should just lose to the black cards, but I did get them pretty low. If I played a bit better, if I'd draw me some 4 drops. Anyways, that one's in the books. Now the one I'm most excited for. Banned Hawkbox band deck, just ramping into Storm the Festival, and then the rest of your deck is everything that hits from Storm. And one cool interaction is that if you had Grafted Identity, you don't have to sacrifice a creature because it's an additional cost to cast the spell, and you're not casting it, you're just putting it into play. So yeah, that's a sweet combo. Welcoming Vamp, I love that card. I don't play it a ton, but it's pretty cool. And then some kind of curves, really solid curve fillers, AO we've seen in action, and some sideboard stuff. I'll try the mana is probably okay. Outarker Waste and Yavimite Coast and a lot of dual lands. How many lands in this deck? Let's see. If I had to guess, Creeper, 6 mana cards, probably like 26. Is that card get 2 lands? Not really. I'd say 26. Hey. 26 lands. Alright, let's do it. Let's see if this deck can get us a couple of wins.
Let's go.
Wow, perfect hands. As easy. Play with some white decks, just Winning Announcement, Wandering Emperor, Bang Buster, the new Sarah Paragon card's pretty solid. There's some power there. It's unclear if it's good enough to compete with the black cards, but there's definitely something there. Let's see. Let's play that to go. I don't know if there's a point in trading. Triple green looking a little sketch though here. Mm-hmm. Could attack with bow. Draws me a card, which could be nice. I think I'm okay with that block. I think I'm gonna just kill the shaman. No treasures for them. I have another Denik in hand. Was a disturb ability. Here's a green source. That's big. One more. The Pious Separation side kind of looks like Joffrey from Game of Thrones. Oh, okay. That's pretty solid. All right, there's triple green. Goodness to that. Never one or more creature cards are printing gravers from anywhere. Investigate. Okay, I'll attack then. All right. Oh, they have blue mana. Ooh. I wasn't paying attention. I heard that blue mana that fires a victory. Could mean make disappear too. That could be trouble. Grace is another really good black glittering check. Yeah. Oof. I mean, I guess just attack with everyone and see what happens, right? Like kind of the slow-mo almost. Well, good news is they're tapped out, so what does that mean? The expel pierce? Don't seem very realistic. Ren and a welcoming vamp. These two combo. But yeah, I'm just gonna pick the two most powerful cards.
I will protect Innistrad's forests As if they were my
kind of tempting to plus. Didn't kill my welcoming vamp for free. Maybe I should have kept the other cards. Well, not for free, but kind of. Can't exile Storm. Don't have other creatures. They got their own. Urtai. I was kind of impressed by Urtai Resurrected. I thought it would be a little worse, but I've been impressed playing it against it. What about you? Do you have any standard decks you really like so far that feels like much better, or is it mostly these black midrange decks? Maybe one of the decks I was playing today. Yeah, okay. Can just get rid of Fable if I want to next turn. Let's see. Start by plussing. Second Storm, that's nice. Okay. Alright, that reflection scares me. Kim's not gonna be over right away. Guess I'll play Denik over holding mana for cycling or Iganjo. Pretty sideboard presence. Maybe I can just straight up kill it, I'm dumb. Alright, immediately regret my decision. That was stupid. Opponent. Oh, what you got? Underdog, okay. It's not too scary. Eternal Grasp? Altered Shard. Okay. All right, 7 mana. Must not escape. Jeez. All right, good enough. Well, Storm was great. Should expect some counters though. Let's see, what do I not love in this matchup? This card, I guess I'll keep it in just because I haven't played with it much. I don't know, everything just seems fine. I don't know, it feels like if they have a decent draw with a few counters, my life could be pretty tough. Oof. Me too, my friend. Me too. Hmm. Boiling substance. All right. Want that plan, please? Oh, no. Not again. I mean, they're both gonna die most likely. I feel like Roller Creeper is a bit worse, and it actually trades City Con just attack. Protection from werewolves. It's kind of a weird attack when you have. Okay, never mind. I was gonna say weird attack just giving you the choice basically. Hopefully that over Katilda since Katilda just dies to removal. Oof. Good card. Is it an air tie? Okay. On that land. Painless blue mana. Hmm. I guess I'm just gonna go for max value. They don't have a counter spell. What the hell? They must have countered, they're playing so aggressively. Yeah. Alright, good beats. Bit of a slow start. Vortex pretty good against AO actually. Still think this looks good though. Damn, it is been a long day. I woke up a little early to the therapist, I guess, for my, I don't know if you call it therapist, physical therapist. I have a tendonitis. Hung out with Harry, we streamed. I went to try and renew my passports, but the pictures I had, the like ID pictures, were not recent enough. They're like over, like they're like a yearish old, year and a half old. Apparently, that's not good. So I have to go back tomorrow morning. It's kind of a nice walk though, as long as it's not raining tomorrow morning. Then we add. I don't know, I gave my blood, and then I got ourselves some good Greek sandwiches. That was nice. All right, I get a 1/1. And I get a 2/2, and then I get some extra little value. Okay. Back on two lands. Is the other side a legend? Oh. Alright. Oh, we're both stuck on land. Okay. Might be time to read what my card does. Whenever it attacks, choose one, exile target creature card from a graveyard. When you do, create a 1/1, exile target non-creature card. Oh, the second ability is kind of nice. Huh. Should I stay back with my 2/2 so then get a free attack? I feel like I might want to. Don't love my chances here. Man's pretty solid in this stumble too. Also have second Kirin coming up. Can I block? Maybe. Okay, I'll take it. All right. Alright, wedding announcement, welcoming vamp. I think this wedding announcement probably. Let's see what I have in the deck boxes. Goblins, maybe. All the same decks I've had for a while now. Survival. I have some pretty City of Brass. Let's see. Soul Transfer, okay. I mean, I guess I just don't do anything. Just play more wedding announcements. Living Death, Wall of Roots, Thrall Surgeon, Spike Weaver, Squee, Radiance Dragoon, Survival of the Fittest. Let's see, let's take a little sample size. Double Swarm Bird of Paradise. Nope. Treasure. They're at 9. My creatures are gonna be huge. Kinda wanna say go in case I have more counters. I mean, getting rid of Reflection seems good though. They're gonna play it now. I don't think they're gonna tap out if they have a counter, especially if I say go with 4 mana. So I'd rather just not give them more draw steps. Draw a counter.
Run away. You'll be safer. You're done.
Boom. Army of tokens. Okay, live with that. I can definitely live with that. All right, I'll bite. Obvious block. I mean, they could earth tie a token, I guess. Alright, opponent, you're killing me here. Oof, Voltage Charge. That's rough. Okay. I mean, I can steal it.
I guess that's it then. Keep watch for intruders.
I can steal it, or I could just play another creature and get a another 2/2. If I steal it, they can air tie it. Not bad. Forces them to do stuff. Probably stealing the thing is fine. Stop the trigger. Just slam the dragon. 6/5. Ayo, I'm tired of technology. Okay, sorry. My best Justin Timberlake impersonation. Not go very well. Let's see. Sample site, sample hand of the Oath of Bird deck. Another corpse, okay. Can you deal with a dragon? That is my question. 5 lands and 2 tutors, and they're all pain lands.
Is
Nice skip. No, doesn't have read ahead. Shout out to Ultimate Guards for making great deck boxes. All size, all material. Also, shout out to Hawkpock for building a deck that can beat the black decks. Alright, I think I'm gonna call it on this win. Take my win. Go on a winning record. I'll definitely be trying that deck a few more matches. That deck, the blue-white deck, was impressive. The red-green list, I kind of struggled to see. I don't know, maybe it's consistent enough and powerful enough to punch through. But yeah, this list is pretty cool. This card was okay for me. I guess it was like kind of a 2-for-1. It got me there. It'll work. Or was that the game I actually lost? Might have been the game I lost. Seems weird that there's nothing better than that, but I've seen other people play that card. I guess it just adds up. The self-mail is kind of whatever. It's okay with Crafted Identity. Yeah, maybe there's just not that many good 2-drops. I mean, we play Spirited Companion in the blue-white deck. The 2-drops are just all limited. But yeah, if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. That was a look at what standard, you know, what can be good in standard if you're trying to not play the black cards. Let me know in the comment if you like it when I play a bunch of different decks or you'd rather me focus on one deck. And yeah, as always, I hope you all have a great week and I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.